Charles H. Charlie Smith was born in the Dust Bowl days of the Great Depression in Seminole, Oklahoma, then spent his early years in Tulsa. When his father returned from service under General Patton in World War II, the Smith family moved to Phoenix. They lived at 40th Street and Oak, where Charlie remembers there was nothing between their house and Scottsdale except alfalfa and cotton fields. He attended Ball's Grammar School, Phoenix Union High School, and the new Camelback High. Inspired by a speech given by the Phoenix Union student body president, Charlie decided to throw his hat in the ring for student government too. He was elected student body president, served as president of the Key Club, the High Y, and lettered in track and wrestling. After high school, Smith attended college at Grand Canyon and Arizona State Colleges, then enlisted in the United States Army. He served as a Nike missile man in the Los Angeles area, was chosen Soldier of the Year of his unit, and was selected to be part of the honor cordon for President John F. Kennedy's inauguration in January of 1961. In 1962, Smith left the Army, returned to the Valley, and moved to Scottsdale, taking a job with a new Dixon Electronics company. Smith bought a Hallcraft home, enjoyed life as a sports-minded bachelor, and then married Sally Garland. They had three children, Alan, Marcia, and Chad. In 1970, the Smith moved way out to a one-acre lot at Hayden and Sweetwater, where they had a huge garden, pets of all kinds, and a braying donkey named Beanie. He moved with Dixon Electronics into its new facility at Pima and Thomas Roads in 1967, and after the company changed hands and names over the years, today still works for Micro Semi in the same building. At the urging of his company, Charlie joined the Scottsdale JCs in 1966. He was elected 1968 Parada del Sol boss when Senator Goldwater served as parade grand marshal, and the rodeo was still held in the old rodeo grounds behind Scottsdale Stadium. He moved up to JC's president the next year and was selected outstanding JC's president in Arizona. He was also named one of the outstanding young men of America. Through the JC's, Charlie got involved in other Scottsdale causes. He served on the Parks and Recreation STEP Committee, the Scottsdale Beautification Committee, and is president of the Foundation for Blind Children, a favorite JC charity. In 1969, fellow JC and friend Herb Drinkwater asked Charlie to help him run for Scottsdale City Council. Herb was elected, and the word spread about Charlie's skills as a campaigner. During the early 1970s, he ran successful campaigns for Mayor Bud Timms and councilmen Dick Campana, Bill Jenkins, Paul Messenger, Billy Gentry, Herb Drinkwater, and Heinz Hink. With experience from terms on Scottsdale Boards of Adjustments and Planning Commission, he was asked to fill Bill Jenkins' city council seat when Jenkins replaced Mayor Timms, who had resigned, to join the Arizona Corporation Commission in 1974. The council welcomed his expertise with number crunching. In fact, Smith remembers that his first council meeting was a tough one. The council, facing a city budget crisis, reluctantly voted to reduce library hours and laid off 50 city employees. Despite a hectic work and civic involvement schedule, Smith found time to complete a degree at Scottsdale Community College and build a woodsy retreat for his family in Pine. He was elected to two more terms on the city council and was an integral part of many landmark actions. Now, during his tenure, Scottsdale started a major urban renewal project, creating the Civic Center Mall, began using incentive zoning as a tool to complete land acquisition for the Indian Bend Wash, thus saving millions of taxpayer dollars, implementing the city's first master plan, as well as one for the McCormick Ranch, Arizona's first master planned community, passed the Hillside Ordinance, and launched Scottsdale's preservation efforts, and annexed huge tracts of land that doubled Scottsdale's size. Smith personally negotiated the city's first contract with United Cable Television. Smith retired from the city council in 1984, but continued to serve as president of the newly formed Industrial Development Authority. He also chaired Scottsdale's Charter Review Commissions in 1986 and again in 1994. In 1981, Charlie became a Scottsdale Charl, serving as patron in 1985. From his perspectives as a Charl and a councilman, he recognized the need to bring Scottsdale Stadium up to major league standards in order to ensure that the San Francisco Giants would continue to hold their spring training there. Well, he spent countless hours on the mayor's baseball study committee, to get the city bond issue passed to fund reconstruction of that stadium. And when it opened for the 1992 spring training season, Scottsdale Stadium, thanks in large part to Smith's efforts, raised the standards for other stadiums in the Cactus League. To further seal the deal, Smith then negotiated a long-term contract between the Giants and the Charles to keep spring training baseball in Scottsdale. Charlie Smith has been Scottsdale's go-to guy for over four decades. A 1980 Scottsdale Progress editorial endorsing him for city council sums up why he has always been a success. It said, "He has been a stickler for details, who thoroughly researches issues, examines expenditures carefully, and works well with other public officials."